Okay, my name is Adrian. I'm going to talk today about the project I work on for this class, which is I design a hand blender and I perform some FEA on it, on the blade. This is a kitchen appliance for blending in pots, in bowls. Everyone pretty much uses it or has one in their kitchens. It's a mechanical system. The main components are a handle in which all the parts, moving and non-moving, are, or at least most of them. There's also the shaft and blade, and also a casing that covers the shaft. My goal here was to design an appliance that is ergonomic, safe, and reliable. And the analysis I chose to make is FEA on the blades, because they are always subject to stresses and deformations, and it's probably the most important part on this appliance, because if it breaks, probably it's not useful anymore. And even if you can replace it in a cheap way, probably the best thing to do would be just buy a new appliance. So this is a survey I did with some products. I chose five from different brands and prices and everything. And this is the kind of tables, analysis tables, that I used to make the comparisons. In the end, I summarized in the table below, like, based on the features of each, what are the pros and cons on the ergonomic side, on the safety and reliability. So that helped me to come up with a final design. These are some sketches that I made for three alternative designs. As you can see, I changed on each of them, like, the ergonomics of it, of the grip. Also, the casing changed, and basically the internal components would be the same on everyone. And again, I created a table to come up with the very final design, with all the advantages and disadvantages of each of these sketches here. This was my final design. Again, I sketched it first, and the way I decided, I created a score table. Like, I rated each of my goals and factors that I wanted to take into account here, and I assigned, like, a grade to them from 0 to 5. And then the one that got the highest score was number 2. But in the end, I decided to grab the best features of the three pre-designs that I had to come up with that even better design. So these are some of the specifications that I set for my design. As you can see here, it's all there. And finally, this is the design that I came up with. One interesting feature I realized, like, for asking people, for example, how they, what type of blender they have at home, for example, and in terms of ergonomics, and they say usually it's not the best or the most comfortable one, because it's hard case, even if it's plastic. So I came up with the idea of also adding like one of those memory foams. I haven't seen a hand blender in the market like this, but it would be nice. Instead of designing for a million shapes of hands, you can have a memory foam that inserts into that, and then that will adapt to every type of hand. So I think that was an interesting feature on my design. And you can see the rest of parts. There's some transparency on the one on your right that shows the components. This is like the exploded view. In total, there's like 21 different parts plus around 4 or 5 screws. So it's a total of 25 parts for this design. And this is some of the 2D drawings that I made of the. These are just single parts that I consider were more difficult or important to show, like the inside or section views. So that's it. Now, the FEA that I perform on this product, I assign different steps. First, I determine the forces in place. Then I selected, I did a convergence analysis to select the best mesh parameters and perform the FEA itself, optimize the design, and finalize the design. Basically, this is all explained in my report, but I came up with a 0.5 newtons per millimeter using like the torque formula for motors. I tried to find in the internet like what would be the forces, but the companies usually don't tell you that. So I came up with a good approximation on it. And this is the convergence analysis that I had first to select the best meshing parameters and then do all my studies based on those parameters. In the end, I'm using a 0.5 global element size and auto transition for it. And you can see after a couple of studies, it starts converging and the stress mesh versus mesh size plot. This is my first study, it's number of plates. So I did two, one for two and one for four. And in the case of four, it got worse. And then the study number two, I analyzed the blade thickness. As you might guess, with a greater thickness, you reduce the stresses on the element. The third study was the blade material. That didn't change a lot. So I used different types of stainless steel. It didn't change at all. So that didn't affect my design. And the different blade profiles, for example, the region one, like the B-shape and then a round one. So the sharper corners you had, the stress was increased in there. So in the end, I summarized the results here, and then I created this flow chart that explains how different factors affected the design, and then came up optimized the design. So this was my final design. I put some rounds in it. I still use a curved shape for the blade, and an increased thickness. And as you can see, from about 15 newtons per millimeter square stress, I reduce it to almost half, like 7. So highlights, I did some freeform modeling. Some of the pieces were intricate, so it was kind of challenging. Others were kind of easy. I designed it for assembly as well, having that in mind, because that's important on the products as well. As you saw on the assembly product, it's pretty easy to assemble. It doesn't have a lot of screws or fastening elements. And I did a comprehensive FPA, which included not one factor, but four. So I think I achieved my goal. This project helped me becoming more proficient with CAD, increased skills needed in industry, of course. To me, the designing was challenging, and this project was challenging and long, but it was fun too. And this is what makes a difference between good and bad products. So I'm just going to quickly show you the website, and the animation is there as well. So in it, I have all my projects. You can go through it. I just want to show you the animation. So that's pretty much it. Does anybody have questions? Yep.
When you did FEA on your blades, did you apply the force normal to the profile of the blade or parallel to the rotational plane?
No, I apply it, since it's a chamfer plate, I apply it just in the direction perpendicular to the rotation axis.
Okay.
But you could have applied also. Actually, I did the first time I did it. I applied, like you say, perpendicular to my chamfer plane. The stresses there were smaller, so I ended up doing it perpendicular to the rotational axis because we want to find out what's the worst case scenario. So that's what I did. So.
Thank you.